Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Action Battle System based on RPG Rail for Bakin. Last time we got the bass down, and ooh, that is really loud. Let me copy and paste this terrain real quick. It is way too loud. Last time we made the base of the system, and I actually had to tweak a little bit because I forgot to add, or I messed up a bit of the calculations. I had this as player X, or this distance X minus player X was the same as right here. That's why they kept falling down. So if you followed it to the T last video, make sure you change that to that. Let me go in here real quick. Copy paste. RD. And change that to. First of all, copied. This one. That's way too loud. Way too loud. Okay, whatever, that's fine, much better. Alright, back to this. So we have our... much better. So we have our base. I made a quick little HP layout right here. Nothing fancy. Because we are going to make it to where the enemy is going to hurt us today. And we're going to make a very basic damage formula. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. We are going to need another cast. We are going to name it E Attack. So we'll call it E Basic Attack. Or we'll just name it E Attack. So the way this system works is you'll have to name it based on the enemy that it's linked to. So I would even go like this and kind of group them together. So that way you have your enemy and their attack combined. So this way if you have multiple attacks, you can kind of work it that way. All right, so kind of set up the exact same way as the players. So we're going to same way. Don't need that anymore. That was for an example for something else. Initialize. That's it for right now. Initialize. It's off. Then we turn it on. Perfect. Switch. Turn it on. Turn it off. And this is the... we'll call it the initialize. And this is going to be... parallel, and this is going to be the hit check. Hit check. So condition, check collision. When the event is a player, or the player for the event. There we go. We have to be able to obtain the data. So this will have to be... enemy target. Okay. There. And then you're going to delete it. control. Now, it's okay that it's a global, because we're going to change that in the event, because we're going to have it linked to a local variable as well. So, control, delete the event, just like the players. And the same thing as before, it just needs to collide with the player. Start once, and then event move, walk in direction facing, player, about 0.75. You should really just copy and paste the basic attack and just rename it. Keep motion, that's it. Okay. Just make sure I didn't miss anything. Yeah, we gotta change the collision. Alright, so about the same as the player. Players. Maybe a little bit taller. There we go. That's fine. Okay. Apply. Go back to your others. Generate in the air. Can, if we want to, generate priority. Make it 0.3. That's fine. Alright. Database. We're going to go back into the enemy. And we need to make another parallel sheet. This is going to be the AI. Basic AI. So, there's numerous ways you can handle AI. We're going to make it so once we get attacked, we're going to make it so they're going to run to the player. And then once it gets to a certain spot, it's going to attack. So we'll do local variable. Ooh, no. When the variable bots of their HP is well, because I did them at HP of 90, but generally you would maybe have their HP at a percentage. We'll say it's less than 80. Then they'll start attacking. I mean, it would probably be a percentage. We can make it a percentage, but we're not going to worry about it right now. We'll make initialize, make sure that is on, and make sure that they are not dead. So, we need to have a variable to as well. So, random AI. Will be between. Two, or you can do 0, 1, doesn't matter. So strip branch, I'm thinking something else. Conditional judgment, check variable bots. If the random AI is 1, then we will do the judgment for 1. If it is 2, then we will do the AI for 2. I forgot we have to go back into here as well, and we need to go ahead and make our stats real quick, because we will need this as well. And we need an attack variable. So let's go ahead and make that too. You can even set the attack up in the what's it called, the attack event, but we're just going to set it here because it's just easier. 2, 5. That's fine. Okay. All right. Set that to basic AI. 1, we won't do anything. 2, we'll attack. So. When that happens, we are going to... Ooh, excuse me. It's late at night. It's 11 o'clock at night. All right. Now, when that happens, we are going to event motion, browse, 2D stamp, elf A. We're going to wait. Then we are going to events. Event motion again. What weapon are we going to give you? We will give you... I'll give you the Morningstar. Why not? Okay. Then we're going to generate the enemy attack. Just did the exact same thing we were doing from the event. Wait until shoot. But we're also going to nest it something else here, too. Control. Wait. 2. Direction, we'll do like 5 steps just so it goes away from the player. Yeah. Okay, but before we do all that, we have to do a raid cast. So this event, the player... is in front of us by 2, should be fine. We'll do that. Cut there. Alright, so if we check this right now, if we test this right now, when the HP is lower. If we test it and the HP is lower than 80, or lower or equal, less or equals than 80, then that should show. So let's go ahead and test that real quick. See. All right, so we need to do a little bit more too. Okay. But it is working, so that's good. That is good. So we need to have it. Face it towards the player too. It'll make our life a lot easier too. Towards player. I'll say if it's like. Four feet away. we don't even need that. Well, no, that's too far. We'll do 1 foot or 1 frame away. Okay. All right, so there, and we need to have. That's right for him. Hit check. This is the initial event. Here, switch. And then again, as long as we're subtracting HP from here, we'll be fine because it's going to be automatically. We don't even need to switch. We're just going to do it automatically. All right. So conditional judgment, collision when this player event one is going to be the target. Is string bumps. The target is the basic attack, is what we named it. I don't remember. Oh, E attack. Let's just make sure that that's working before we keep going. Oh, it's shooting it out. Oh, I think I know why. I think it's because the 2D stamp. I don't know if that's actually a collision. That's odd. Oh, you know what it is? I forgot. It's the handle all of that right here. Yep. Okay. So. Yeah, so I don't even need a collision check. It's only for the player. All right. So to begin. Let me double check. And this event is in contact. Yeah. So that should do it, hopefully. So I forgot that it's all handled through the event. Yep, perfect. Alright. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have to put a weight on that. This is gonna be killing me quick. Alright. So we'll have to do a control. Oop, not start loop. Control weight. We'll do about a second. Okay. So going back to this, we don't even need the players. All this. It's all one. But. Yeah. Okay. Can you feel it? Can you feel it? I said I'm gonna let it taste the juice. Now we're gonna shake 'em all down. Okay. Yeah. So you'll want to use the attack power of the cast's attack because it has to be handled through the generated events. Okay, that's right. Okay, so. Damage. Alright. So a super simple damage formula is just damage equals HP attack time or attack minus defense, and then you subtract it to your HP. So super simple. We're gonna do that. Damage. We'll assign that to. If you believe like I believe, shake 'em all. She'll have to set all that here. So when the event generates, we'll go ahead and set the values here. The attack is going to be the cast status of the enemies. This enemy's attack, which is this one right here, their attack power. Makes it a lot easier to handle. So there. Apply. Go back to the player. We gotta set his information too. So we'll set that here as well. So here. Is equal to the cast status of the player. The current HP, we'll assign that. And we'll assign the defense to the defense power as well. Alright, so going back to the event. We're almost done. Once I get his attack going, we'll stop and I think we'll pretty much be good, because you should be able to handle it from there, because got the player and an enemy attack. That's really all you need. You can kind of build from there. Okay, almost done. So, attack, go over here, hit check. So, there we go. So this is the kind of the one bad thing about Bakin is you kind of have to break it down. And then damage, grapple box, def, subtraction, and then grapple box, damage. Because we can't do like A equals B plus C, it has to be A equals C or something like that, or A equals B then A equals plus C. It's you have to break it down and it's a pain. Hopefully they'll change it eventually, but anyways, so whenever this event is in contact with the player, we're going to change the motion to damage. It's going to do the damage effect. Excuse me. And then we're going to assign the attack. Excuse me, I had a peanut stuck in my throat. To damage. And then we are going to subtract the defense from the damage and then subtract the HP to the damage. Subtract the damage to the HP. All right, let's see how that works or how that looks. Shouldn't hurt us too bad. And then we'll have put the new formula into the enemy as well. Let's see, didn't hurt us. So, there's a reason why that's not working, or not showing on screen. Whenever you're messing with the values with Bakin, you have to make sure that you are doing it with the statuses as well. So, we have to subtract here, and let me do this as well, real quick. So right here, we'll do our damage calculations. Same way we did it before. So, damage is fair box, attack. Defense. And the damage. Minus the HP. have to subtract the damage from the status. So HP this enemies decrease by the damage. Okay. So that should work now. So this should be taking it from their defense. So if we test it, that's not right. Oh, you know why? I think it's assigning players damage. I think I did that wrong. Yep, that's why. I'm like, that's not right. Okay. So let me make sure that that's correct before I continue. Enemies, LHP. Yes, okay. So that should work. Hopefully. Have it backwards. Yeah. HP the damage. There you go. And let me change that to player too. That'll mess up. That'll just keep healing me. That should do it. Okay. As well for the other calculations. No, that's right. And I think it's like this. Excuse me. Yeah, it should be like that now. Okay. I apologize. The way they word the values in Bakin are a little confusing. Okay. Ooh. Ooh, geez. Yeah, that did quite a bit. Okay. So, yeah. Ooh, yeah. We got to change that up a little bit. But, yeah. There you go. See? It works. Yeah. needs to be 0.1. Enemy attack, hit check, swap all this around as well. Okay, that should be better, hopefully, we'll see. There we go. Oof. Okay. Yeah, we definitely need a longer wait in between. But, yeah, that's kind of the gist of it all. We'll wait, like... 2 seconds in between. See, that's a bit better. Yeah, there's a lot of tweaking to do. Collide with allies. Maybe that's what I need, because I think as soon as it collides with allies, it should be disappearing. Okay, so that's a little bit better. Okay. Cool. So yeah, it does work. All right, guys, I think that's all for now. I think next time, I don't think there really needs to be a next time. I think two videos should be plenty. This is definitely a good base to go from. If you have any questions, just hit me up in the Discord. So thanks for watching, and I will see y'all in the Discord. Bye-bye.